Although mouth is accessible to examination by a dentist or a clinician and self-examination by a patient, but irony of the fact is early detection of oral cancer lesions and precancerous conditions are far from reality. Today in this video, I am going to discuss about potentially pre-malignant conditions like oral submucous fibrosis and the stages of oral submucous fibrosis. So stay tuned and watch the video till last. Oral submucous fibrosis is a chronic condition which affects the mouth, restricting its mouth opening and leading to leathery consistency of inner side of the cheeks, that is called buccal mucosa, further can lead to development of oral cancer. A person or a clinician in cases of oral submucous fibrosis, when uses his finger and roll the finger inside of the lip and inside of the cheek, he or she may feel there is a leathery consistency as well as marble-like consistency inside the mouth. This condition is a chronic condition, means this condition has developed over a period of time. The major causative factor for oral submucous fibrosis or precancerous condition is chronic chewing of areca nut or betel nut and tobacco. Whenever a person chews tobacco or areca nut or betel nut, there is a release of alkaloid. These compounds has alkaloids which causes dryness of the mouth, as well as there is a constriction of the muscle or inside of the tissues. Now, what are the stages of oral submucous fibrosis or this precancerous condition? Why this is called precancerous? Because the chances of getting oral cancer after disease is very high as compared to a person who doesn't have this disease. Now, I will tell you about the stages of oral submucous fibrosis. First is early stage. In this stage, there is no visible symptom. There is a slight change in texture of the inside of the lining of our mouth and the throat. Patient may experience slight burning sensation while taking any spicy or acidic foodstuffs. In this disease, there is restricted mouth opening. It affects the mouth opening of a person. Now we have to understand how to count the mouth opening. It is the distance between the edge of the upper central incisor and edge of the lower central incisor. Whenever a patient's open mouth fully, in early stage disease, the mouth opening will be between 26 to 35 mm approximately. Moderate stage. In this stage, patient experiences moderate burning and itching sensation inside the mouth. Along with, patient may experience stiffening of the lining of the mouth, that is called oral mucosa, and dryness of the mouth. And when we see the mouth opening, it will be between 15 to 25 mm approximately. Advanced stage. In this stage, the contraction of the lining of the mouth or oral mucosa is more severe and leading to decreased mouth opening. The burning and itching sensation are more intense, leading to difficulty in eating certain foodstuffs. In this stage, a person can find red and white patches inside the mouth, either on the palate or on the buccal mucosa or the inner side of the cheeks or inside the lip. The mouth opening will be less than 15 mm. Last is the severe stage. In this final stage, the lining of the mouth or oral mucosa becomes severely contracted, leading to severe decrease in mouth opening. Eating and speaking become extremely difficult and challenging, and patient may land up into eating soft or liquid diet. The burning and itching sensation are very severe in these cases, and there are visible white and red patches inside the mouth. There are multiple ulcer may be present and scarring of the lining of the mouth. In some cases, patient may find loss of sensation in particular area or whole of the mouth, depending upon the severity of the disease which has progressed. It is important to note that not all the patient will go to all these stages, and progression will vary between person to person. It is important to seek medical help from an oral and maxillofacial surgeon as soon as possible to prevent further progression of the disease and manage the symptom effectively, and to prevent the conversion of this condition to oral cancer disease. I will conclude this video. Hope you like my video. Kindly share with your friends and family members, and please subscribe my channel. Take care. Stay healthy. Bye-bye.